Can you hear the sound? Hola amiguitos, hola, I'm Ulises Cruz and this is Plant Based Masterpiece. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? So right now I'm showing you how to make chips. I'm gonna make it a little spicy, that's why I have right here my smoked paprika. It's optional. You can use cayenne, Thai chili, cayenne, or also chipotle, chipotle powder, chipotle adobo. I know, it is optional, it's up to you. It's almost 1 cup of chopped bell pepper. Right now I'm gonna cut it. 1 cup of suck cashews. SOAKED cashews. What else? 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt. You can use Himalayan salt. And 1/2 tablespoon of nutritional yeast, the cheesy flavor. Also, you need 1 food processor. If you don't have a food processor, you can use your blender. I don't know if I say before lime, but I'm gonna use 1 lime. Also, it's something like 1/2 tablespoon of lime, but this is too small. I'm gonna add it a little more. So, it's time to do it. Let's put this aside right here. So, and I'm gonna chop my bell pepper. Just in small pieces because I don't wanna give hard times to my food processor, that's why. Also, I already wash and it's not dry, but I already wash it and it's clean, is the most important. Ta-da-di-ta-da-da! So, in our food processor, we're gonna break down a little bit for cashews. So before turning into butter, it's time to add all rest of the ingredients. Oh, I say the rest. You can add it all or little by little, you know, it's optional. Now. Right now I'm trying to make some like a smooth texture. Daddy. It's my strainer. If you're on this embarrassing situation, I mean it's too dry, and how I don't have patience right now. Right now, I'm gonna do something crazy. Add a little water. Solo, just poquito. Wow, this is magic. It's going good? It's going good. It's going perfect. Also, all this about that test. You should try it if it's going good. If this is what are you looking for, is this what are you love? Why no more spicy? I can't believe it. It's time to use this glove. So right now, just make sure watch your kale. And right now, how it's a lot, I'm gonna toss the hot portion first. So wash and let it drain a little bit. Don't add it more water because you're gonna lose the flavor. So right now it's time to dust it or cut it. Also, when you're doing this, this is important. Just give it a little massage. Just break down a little bit that kale. Just a little bit like. So right now it's time to place on or over or non-stick dehydrator sheet. So when you are doing this, or when you're cleaning your kale, just make sure some kind of chips size, not like a whole leaf. Actually, it's optional. It's time to place in my dehydrator. So I'm gonna dehydrate it by 24 hours, also overnight. And tomorrow I'm gonna see how it's going, everything. Just I'm gonna make sure that this dry and it's nothing of moisture in here. I'll be back. So then, amiguitos, amigos, look at these kale chips. It's so beautiful, right? Look at this, so cheesy. Also, it's crunchy. Right now, I'm gonna save everything in this container. Also, you can save on other bags or also in containers too. You can save that by months. I mean, it's not gonna be expired. And also, you can snack them anytime. Also, I love you can share the kale chip with your friends. Can you hear the sound? So then, amiguitos, this is how it really looks like the kale chips. I mean, if you see, those are crispy and really look like cheesy flavor. Looks like cheddar color. The flavor is incredible. This is not really spicy how I really wanted, but this is spicy for someone. Also, if you can hear a little bit, it's something crispy. So thank you. If you like this video, tell me what would you like to see on the next videos. Also, if you like this video, give me one thumb up and comment what would you like to see on the next videos, please. Just get the recipe and make your own kale chips. Thank you for staying until this part of the video. See you soon. Peace and love to the kale chips. Bye, amiguitos.